Buddy, this is Mr. Haig. Hope you're having a good day. So we are now introducing you to a brand new tool. And so what I'm going to ask you to do now is go ahead and open up Photoshop. You should have the start screen here. And I'm going to also have my handy dandy sticky note here so I can write down notes. This will also be available to you if you need that, and I'll have this in the directions as well. So we're going to go into more complex tools, and although these tools are not as complex as you might think, but they're still, obviously we went through the marquee tool. You guys did great on that one. So let's go ahead and create new, and you should have, again, if you saved your preset, I've got one that says 2000 by 2000 pixels, 72. So there's 1000 by 1000, but I'm going to go ahead actually and not do that. I'm going to go into 1000 by 1000 only for teaching purposes, because I'm going to remind you one of the steps that we have to do is open Canvas. So why don't I go ahead and ask you, okay? Now, again, a lot of you are making a mistake of choosing, not choosing pixels, you're choosing inches. You need to make sure it's pixels. So 1000 by 1000, 72 pixels per inch, white background. Okay? Be very simple. So if you have that, okay, again, at any time, stop and rewind this video. So let's go ahead and press create. And here is our canvas, okay? And so we're gonna need two of them, but let's just go ahead and hold off on a second. So this here is the lasso tool, and the lasso tool, as you see, is demonstrated, allows you to s manually select an image manually. In other words, you can go ahead and by hand, okay? Now if you're gonna use your mouse, it may be a little bit of a challenge, but you guys can do it. Okay, so the first thing you should have, and if I go back, you should have stems.psd. So you should download that from your Google Clouds. I'm sorry, your should download that from your Google Classwork. Sorry, I'm hearing voices back behind me. Okay, so let's go ahead and move forward. First of all, from your classroom, the Google Classroom for your respective periods, you should have downloaded the lesson 2.zip. Okay, and if you have the Photoshop folder on your downloads, like I'd ask, or if you can put it wherever you want as long as you can find it, but I always believe in organization. So I'm going to go ahead and move this into the Photoshop folder, and notice this says lesson 2, and then you have the previous unit 11. So now I'm going to move lesson 2 into less unit 11. Okay, and then all I got to do now is for you Mac users, okay, once again, I'll go ahead and write this down, to unzip and go ahead and ignore what I said about, okay, for Mac people, you just double click. Okay, and then for Windows, you just basically right click and then you uncompress or unzip. Maybe one of you guys can tell me which one it is. All right, so all I'm going to do now is, okay, I'm going to double click. There it goes. There's lesson two. Once I have these, I can go ahead and right click, move to trash, discard that. So I've got my two files that I need, and obviously I'm going to right click, open with Photoshop. Or, you can, again, I try to drag this in, but it all depends on, I wouldn't drag it in. You can only drag files in if you're in the start screen. If you have a canvas available or open, it's going to drag it into that canvas and you don't want it. So again, I'm just going to drag this in, both of them in. Let's see if I can do that. I'm not sure. So, okay, that worked. Okay, so, if I had a canvas, okay, file new. Okay, so let me go ahead and bring back. If I brought in a canvas, watch what happens. Okay, I'm going to drag it into this canvas, and that's what's going to happen. And you might think, okay, there's nothing wrong with that. No, but it's actually it might cut off things, and anyways, just don't do it. Okay, I guess we got lucky here because the canvas here is the same as, the first one. But let me go ahead and demo again. Let me undo this one. Let me go ahead and show you again what happens. And also, this comes in as a smart object. You see that? This little icon right there, smart object thumbnail. Okay, I'm not going to go into that right now. I won't explain it. It's a little more details. And we're not going to go into smart objects in this class. But let's go ahead and put in stems and watch what happens. Okay, again, this resizes everything, so we kind of don't want that. I like the way it is right here. Okay, so it's exactly where I want it to be. Not smaller, not a lot of dead space. So at any rate, you should have three things now. Okay, you should have the empty canvas, 1,000 by 1,000. You should have the stems. You should have the flowers. Okay, so let's go move forward. And what we're going to do now, okay, first of all, your flowers, we're going to place the flowers on these stems here. Okay, very simple. And you can change and arrange this any way you want. Just keep in mind that layer 3, when I right click layer 3, okay, so here's layer 3. How do I know? I just press that I and it disappears. You've got two stems at once. So let me show you the first thing I would use the lasso tool. Okay, so everybody make sure you highlight the, you know what, let's just do this. Let's call this, let's double click and call it two stems. Let's see, which one is this one? This one is curve stems. Okay. And this guy right here, the small one, is, let's call it small stems. Okay, now watch what happens. With a curved stem, I can actually move this a little bit out, okay? So give it much more space. Now, with the two stems, let's go ahead and select the lasso tool. Now, again, you got to be very careful. I'm talking lasso tool, okay? Not the other two. So if I click here, okay, trying to click there, click and hold. It'll say lasso, polygon, or magnetic. We want to choose lasso. Now, watch this. Again, two stems. I spelled stems wrong. Stems. Two stems. I'm going to make sure now, and another thing you want to make sure is when you click on the lasso tools, on the very top, you have these selections here. Now remember how we created those marquee tools with a circle, and we're able to, kind of like subtract an area. Let me remind you. I'll create a new layer. Please do not do this part. Do not do this part. So I create layer one, okay? And if I create a circle, and I either press the Alt key, or I press this one, this icon right here, where it says subtract from selection. Okay, and if I subtract it, there, see that happens? And if I add, which is this icon right here, okay, if I add, then see, notice there's a plus sign on the lower right, and I can actually add to it. So we did something there. Now to deselect, okay, remember to deselect, okay, marching ants, you can either press out on the white canvas, okay, doesn't have to be white, it can be even transparent canvas, or you can just press Command D or Control D. That's what you can do. So here I'm just gonna press out. Okay, I'm gonna press the marquee tool and out. Actually, you have to have it in normal. So maybe it's just better to do Command Control D. There, it's gone. And always make sure that you're back in the first icon, the new selection mode. Okay, not in any of these modes. And if you're wondering what intersect with selection is, I'll show you really quickly. I can do this. Make sure that last icon is selected. And notice the lower left is an X. That stands for intersection. And I can click here and look at that. And I get a little whatever is not selected, this little football shape. Okay, Command D. So anyways, let's not get off track, but I just wanted to make sure you understand that. Okay, and I'm going to go ahead and right click and delete this layer. So back to two stems, and I'm going to go ahead and watch this. I'm going to basically select this and give it its own layer. So I'm just going to kind of guide along there. There we go. And I'm just, okay, so once I've selected it, okay, two stems. So what I'm going to do is first use the lasso tool to select around the stem. And then I'm going to copy it. And then paste, and it'll paste into its own layer. Okay, so watch what I did. Okay, so I've already copied this, and I'm just going to, I can actually do edit copy, okay, or edit paste, whatever that could be, or edit cut even. I can even choose edit cut. Let's go ahead and do this. Let's do edit cut. Okay, so I'm going to change this, sorry. Cut, which is, by the way, Control X or Command X, and then paste. So that way, because when we copy it, it may not actually remove it from its area. So watch what happens when I copy. Edit copy, and then edit paste. Okay. Notice that, whoops, when I use the move tool and move it around, notice the original is still there, so it doesn't help it. So what we want to do now, and I'll go ahead and use the history tool to go back. Okay, so we're back here. And then is edit cut. Now it's gone. And then I'm going to edit paste. There you go. And now I'm going to move it. It's got its own. So now I'm going to call it, it was originally called two stems. You may want to, just call it stem one and then call it stem two. All right. So now we got this guy here. Let's go ahead and once again use the move tool. There's stem two and move it right there. Okay. We're ready to go. And we can always increase the size such as such. There we go. Maybe make it a little bit skinnier. All right, now we're ready to go to the flowers. So now we have this scenario. Okay, so we're going to go into the flower PSD. We're going to choose the lasso tool, and let's go ahead and choose. I'm going to choose, let me think. Well, why not? Let's just make things easier. Let's go ahead and zoom in a little bit, and hopefully I'm able to zoom in and do that. So if you notice, I'm kind of like delicately kind of cut. There we go. And the thing about the lasso tool is it allows you to go into the grooves, as you can see. And you don't have to, but the whole purpose is so you don't have to spend too much time removing the outskirts. So that's what I have right there. And this time I could copy it if you want. You know, I'm going to go ahead and edit copy or Command C. So I'm going to do that. Oops. Oh, and another thing I remember. Okay, so before we do that, that little signal gave me another choice. This is why I have you guys watch first, okay? Because I'm realizing some of the things I should have done. I wasn't thinking. Well, you notice that I got that little notification there. So let me do it again. I'm just going to go ahead and just kind of crudely. And I'm going to copy it, but notice I get this signal. Could not complete the copy because the selected area is empty. Well, what does that mean? It means that my layer here hasn't been selected. So this layer where all these flowers are not selected. So I'm going to go ahead, see that? The layer 3 is highlighted, but not layer 1, which is the series of flowers. So I have to make sure layer 1 is selected. However, to make things easier for you, I'm just going to flatten the layers and make everything into one. Okay, let's do that. The way to do that is go up to the hamburger icon right here, click, okay, and go all the way down to where it says flatten image. Okay, so once again, the hamburger icon, okay, right here, click, and go all the way down to flatten image. There you have it. All right, that's it. Now we've got one layer, and that's it. And now I can go ahead and copy this, and I'll do it again, because that selection was kind of crudely done. So I'm just going to go ahead and do that, and you don't have to. You can just kind of go around as best as you can, but try not to cut into the flower like I just did. Okay, so if that's the case, I just start again. So again, you may want to just carefully, I'm cutting into the other flower. So let's go ahead and do this. All right, and there we go. Okay, now I got it. Now I can either cut or I can copy. And I'm going to go ahead and copy. So edit, copy, and I'm going to go to the stems and edit, paste, or Command V. Notice now that appears. I'm going to move it here, and of course that looks like it's totally you've got, first of all, it's too small of a petal, so I'm going to, it should automatically come with handlebars, so you can just kind of make it bigger, and let's go ahead and do that, and let's go ahead and press return. Okay, so the way to do this, of course, is what we did was we flattened the image. Okay, first we did was flatten the image. So the steps, first thing we did was flatten the image. Okay, flatten the PSD file. And once we did that, we don't have to worry about selecting the layers. And then what we did was we used the lasso tool to select around the area we wish to copy. And then what we did was we copied, okay? So we edit, copied, or whatever, Command C. And then we went to the stems PSD canvas, and we edit, paste. There you go. Of course, and then the handlebar should still be there, and we increase the size of the petal or the flower, whatever you want to call it. And the move tool should also be available, but using the move tool, move the flower into its place. All right, that's how the steps are. It will be available in the notes. Let's go ahead and do another one. All right, let's go ahead and press the marquee tool, okay, and notice the marching ants are still marching. This time you can't just move it over because this selection is jagged, and in some, actually that's pretty good. Look at that, it still fit in there, but in other cases it'll cut into the flower, although that selection is pretty darn good. Look at that. Well, anyways, I want you to get the practice, so I'm going to go ahead and deselect and select the lasso tool. This time I'm going to choose the purple one. Purple's been my favorite color for a long time, so I'm just going to keep it zoomed out so I can better control it. And again, you can just kind of, whoops, messed up immediately. Again, just kind of like, there you have it. Okay, there you have it. Okay, and now I'm going to Command C or Edit Copy. I'm going to go to the layer here, and I'm going to go ahead and paste. There it is, and notice that you have layer 2 and layer 1, okay, and over here you may want to rename it to call it Purple Flower if you want to do that, and the layer 1 is the red flower if you want to do that. select the purple flower. Let's go ahead and let's use the move tool to move it exactly where it, whoops. I'll explain what that little thing is. So now we want to expand it a little bit. There we have it. Now, immediately you see there's a little issue here with the white. Excuse me. All right, well, the next tool we're going to be learning down the road is the wand tool, but let me introduce you right now. So if you click the wand tool, okay, and you select the purple flower, beneath the purple flower, I can select that area. Okay, notice that, how, notice the white is selected. That's the thing about the lasso tool. You want to have as less area for me to have to select and remove. So then I'm going to press delete, and notice that it now the stem goes into the flower. Let's do that for the flower thing, and boom, there we go. Again, now it looks pretty cool. All right, let's go ahead and choose another flower. Flatten image. Let's go ahead and choose the lasso tool. And this time, you know, like I said, you can go ahead and use the lasso tool. I'm going to use this one right here. So let me go ahead and carefully, again, like I said, it's not a perfect science. You can just go ahead and do the best you can. Okay. Again, we're selecting so we don't have to remove as much. Now, removing this white is not a bad thing. It's when we get to more complex images with a lot of colors, where you, with a magic wand tool, you'll understand once we get into the magic wand tool. Okay, so I got the flower selected. I'm gonna go ahead and edit copy, or Command C, copy, go into the stems and edit paste. Edit paste. Okay, and there it is right there. I'm gonna use the move tool to move it right over here. I'm gonna bring it up and notice kind of, now this time you'll notice that the flower is behind that image. Why is that? Okay, well, that's going to be something we need to deal with right now. If you look at this image right here of the stems, the reason is because this stem is above, as a layer, is above the flower. So here is the flowers. Notice if I click on the eye right here, it's layer one. So I'm going to call it pink flower. But the small stem is right here. Notice that? So it's way up there. So to solve this, I will either move the stem flowers down or the pink flower up. Let's go ahead and bring the stem down, right down there, so it can join the other stems. See, there you go. All right, there you have it. Now I'm going to use the magic wand tool, select the pink flower, and select right underneath it. Boom, there it goes, delete, we got it. And notice that there's a little discrepancy over here with the stems. You've got these little checkered things. Well, let's go ahead and click on the small stem. Okay, and click on the outburst. There we go, and get rid of that. There we have it. Okay, one more flower to go. This lovely yellow flower looks good. So again, this time I'm just gonna be interested in just selling. There we go. And by the way, also another really good thing I want to show you is that once I select around it, okay, and I'm going to do it again. Let's see. There we go. And if I'm at this point right here, I can just let go. I can release the mouse and notice it just kind of connects it. But you got to be careful, okay? It looks like the marching ants are just above that green leaf over there. So I'm going to go ahead and Command C, go back to stems. Command V, there we have it. All right, and one more time, you may want to use the magic wand tool to remove that white. There we go. And do I need to? Yeah, it should be a little bit bigger, I suppose. There we go. There we go. Okay, cool. I like it. All right, now that's a pretty picture. Now here's my challenge. Now layer one is, let's call this the yellow flower. Okay, there we go. So now we got flower, flower, flower. What I'd like you to do now is select 1, 2, 3. Press and hold the shift key, or press and hold the command key. 1, 2, maybe, or maybe it's just a shift key. Yep, command key works too. So select all these, and what you remember, and we're going to group them into flowers and stems. So, click and new group from layers. Okay, call it flowers. There we have it. And then select these guys, the stems. Okay, click on the hamburger icon, new group from layer, call it stems. There we have it. And then what I'd like for you to do now is go ahead and file save this. Okay. Why don't you, instead of calling it stems.psd, well, I guess you can call it stems.psd, but I'm going to challenge you to call it, first of all, save as, okay. Save as, and let's go into the save document, okay, into the cloud. Okay, let's go ahead and first save it into the cloud, okay, into chapter unit 11. And this time you can create another folder. So click on the folder icon, okay, and call it lesson 2 or L2, lesson 2. Now you're in L2, okay, and then go ahead and save. There you have it. Okay, pretty cool. And you'll notice, of course, now this becomes a, you notice that there is a cloud there. Okay, let me go deeper. There's a cloud there, and then there's also the, it's called PSDC, and the C stands for cloud. Now I'm going to ask that you go ahead and save this in your computer. File, save as. And let's, it'll say right here on your computer, click there. And then what you'll do is you can, well, I don't want, for me, I'm going to call it stems complete. Okay, instead of overriding the original stems, I would call it stems complete. There we go. Okay, and then press save and use the form to upload this into your Google, into so you can be graded. Okay. Hopefully, this will solve everything. Well, not solve, but hopefully, you're enlightened by this. And that's all she wrote.